Okay, so I took the same build that we have here to two separate tournaments this week, going X1 on a three rounder on Wednesday and 2-2 on our Saturday tournament. Losing to Tri Brigade on Wednesday in the last round, and then losing to the 35 card or the 35 trap Eldritch deck and fucking Altergeist. God damn, I just cannot seem to beat that fucking deck for the life of me. I just cannot beat this Geist player at my locals. So I went back to 40. I like this list a lot. It seemed to be the most consistent. On paper, it seems like the most consistent way that you could play this deck with as minimal garnets as possible. Something that I would like to note before we begin was I played just two of this because I was trying to make room for other cards. And then I played this and these. And the reason why I want to bring this up is I almost played the Psy Engine, where it would be two Reflector, one Beast, and then this I always considered to be the Trap, the Assault Mode, and then these would be the Teleports. So I almost played that engine, but I don't know, man, I'm just a fucking coward, I guess, and just couldn't bring myself to not play this card. But I also didn't want to play three of it, because I did a lot of testing before the Wednesday tournament and before the locals on Saturday, and I kept opening too many non-tuners. So I kind of wanted to try to mitigate that by, you know, slimming down at least like one copy of the level twos. And this was like the most cuttable of, you know, Doppel Converter in this card. That's the most cuttable. So I went ahead and cut him down to two. I tried the Psy Engine a lot too over the week while I was doing my testing. And it's insane. It really is insane. But when it came, like push comes to shove, when I went to the tournament, I don't know. I guess I'm just a coward. Couldn't bring myself to try to play it. But I think this list is fine. I ran into a lot of issues, though, that are just kind of inherent with the deck, which I'll kind of talk about as we get into the profile more. But 4-3 overall across two tournaments. I played literally the exact same list, except for one change in the extra deck was I played this in the second tournament, and I played Quandax in the first tournament. The reason I put this in for the second tournament was because I never summoned the Quandax during the first tournament. Because a lot of times, whenever I have jump Doppel, or if I'm going like this guy in Doppel, and when we get Speeder and the two tokens, I usually opt to go for the Excel route first. So I'll go the Excel route and then make Speeder at the end. So I can get like the Herald up here and like the Herald before the Speeder. So I never had the line where you go from Shaman to Quandax to Excel to Metal Marcher to get all the draws. I just never did that because, again, it's like I always wanted to go the safer route whenever I had the Doppel play. So I don't know. It is what it is. But then, you know, I played this on Saturday and it's really good. Don't get me wrong, but it's like very matchup dependent. Like I summoned this against the Eldritch player, and you know, Torrential Strike is just insane. You know, it's just like it is what it is. Just like really, Strike just kind of obliterates you. It's kind of a problem because like even like a combination of like Conk and then Strike, whenever you try to like negate it with something, it's just, you know, it's unfortunate. It is what it is, though. So, like, in the grind, the reason this was bad in that matchup was in the grind game, this ended up kind of just, like, fucking me in the long run. It's not like it died, it just sat on the board the whole time. And I imagine he left it on the board. Shout out Nick Ortiz, the guy's an insane player. But I imagine he left it on the board the whole time because he knew that it would kind of, like, ruin any recursion that I had through, like, a normal summon junk line into, you know, trying to synchro climb, so. Yeah, I don't know, I probably won't play the Shenshin going forward, but again, like I said, it was literally same exact list, main extra side. I've changed one card for the profile because I just want to say what I'll be playing going forward in the video, what I'm going to try next, so I might as well give you like the most updated version of the deck that I can. But anyway, 4-3 across two tournaments, you know, it is what it is. It's really hard to beat trap decks, and my fucking try opponent in the first tournament is just insane. Shout out Jad. I actually have his profile coming later this week as well, this coming week. But anyway, we'll quit, you know, babbling. We'll get into the deck. There's not really a ton to talk about, so I'll just kind of talk about shit as we go. You know, three of these, you have to play this. We're just gonna kind of just lay out the engine here. Three Dawn, three Junk, three Doppel, Caligo, just the two, like I said. was trying this out. It was, like, fine. I don't know. I'm still kind of here nor there on this card at this point. Like, don't get me wrong. It is, like, insane. It's very necessary, I feel like, to include this card in your deck. And it does serve its purpose. And it did serve its purpose. But there's a lot of times where I'll open something like Talents, Overtake, like this card, and then I'll have this and this guy, and it's like, okay, I have one line of play, and then I kind of just boned after that. Like, I make like a Crystal Wing, I guess. But because Imperm is just everywhere, so it's like it's a lot harder to resolve Triple Tactics Talents, at least at my locals, because just everyone's playing Impermanence. So I just feel like I'm never really getting Ash Veilered, and you know, it's just, it's kind of unfortunate, because you know, obviously the idea with playing the talents is like, okay, you Ash here, okay, you Veiler here, now I look at your hand and then I combo anyway, but it just never worked out that way for me. Not to say that I'm not going to play Talents, because Talents is just insane. I definitely better than Crossout in my testing. I tested both a lot this week as well, and Talents is just simply just better. Crossout just doesn't resolve enough, so, whereas Talents will have, you know, a higher chance of resolving. But anyway, yeah, Crow, like, it's good. I'm going to keep playing it, but that was just my issues with it. Three Overtake, one Rota, and then the one ofs, the Ants, the Cyber Synchron, the Trail, the Illumination. Okay, so I opened this so much. I literally opened this like probably 7 or 8 games of the 7 rounds that I played. It was fucking insane how much I kept opening this card. It wasn't like terrible, but it's just, it could have been like anything else and I would have liked that more. I did not open this guy a lot, and I fucking constantly open this card, which again isn't even the worst if we can get junk to resolve with Converter or something like a Shaman later bring back with Converter to get this card back. But it just was, I don't know, man. I opened like these together a lot too, so that's kind of unfortunate. But man, I don't know what it is. It's like, this isn't really, like, I feel like these two aren't really Garnets. This kind of not really either, because like I said, if we can pitch with Converter and get it back, it just doesn't matter. Like, your speeder 2-1 Converter just is basically your speeder for 3 still. But man, I don't know, it's just unfortunate, because I would open like these in tandem with each other, like any combination of these four. But you know, you kind of figure without the Psy Engine, these realistically are like your only quote-unquote Garnets. You have 3, that's it, and it's like as clean cut as you can get it, because you gotta play these. Unfortunately, you just have to play these cards. They're just too good to pass up. But man, I just fucking kept opening these two. Specifically these two, mostly Trail though. So, you know, it just is what it is. It would be, you know, game 3 and I'm opening these Garnets instead of my sideboard. That was something that happened a lot, was I just didn't really see my sideboard a lot. And I'm siding in like 6 to 7 cards in a lot of these matchups, and I'm just not seeing my side deck. So, I don't know. It is what it is. Not really a ton I could do about that, but it's, you know, when you're playing against these trap decks, you just need to be able to see the twins and so on and stuff like that, but it just didn't end up happening for me. I saw these cards instead, but, you know, this engine I think is fine. I wouldn't change anything. I didn't really miss tuning at all. I think that the Overtake kind of does what we're trying to do with tuning. The only thing that's good about the tuning is you can set like the Converter for Stardust up a lot more like consistently, and tuning Mill can be nuts as well. I may try tuning again at some point, but I don't know as of right now. All right, so then we have all of our non-engine Reborn, Upstart. So this was Fossil, and this was something else that I kept bricking on, where like I would just open like a lot of Interaction and then like this card and a non-tuner, and it just like doesn't do anything. So I don't know, I just ended up cutting it from the deck altogether. Reborn's just like too good to not play. And the problem with Fossil is like, it's insane whenever we can go Converter, pitch, they Ash, and then you like revive a tuner, and then you special Doppel Warrior from hand, and then you can like, you know, you can go Synchro Summon for Excel or even go for Speeder. Don't get me wrong, that play is insane, but that play is more or less relying on the fact that like you have Doppel, or if you don't have Doppel, then your Chaos Ruler resolving to get you into Doppel to make this live. So, you know, unfortunately, when you reborn the level 2s, like the Converter or the Doppel, you don't get their effect because the monster gets banished. So, I don't know, like, in theory, it's really good, of course, because it's just another copy of this, and this can help you finish out your end board, but I kept bricking on this card, so I ended up cutting it from the deck. I spoke with Nick Ortiz after the tournament, just very briefly. He was kind of testing hands of the deck, and he's like, why aren't you just playing Upstart instead of this? It seems a lot better. Like, he's like, I feel like the Fossil just, like, doesn't do enough. And he's like, maybe the Upstart can like potentially just be that one card that you're missing to have a line of play or two lines of play. And you know, he tested some hands and just kind of pretended the fossil was upstart, and yeah, I mean, it seemed good. I mean, it's just the theory of, you know, 39. It's just, we're trying to make the deck as consistent as possible already, so why not try to include a card like this that's just going to be just a blank, something that you can just immediately cycle. So I don't know, I haven't tested with it enough. This is something that could come out for tuning as well, so I don't know. But anyway, you know, upstart goblin. And then we have the hand trap lineup. I played a lot. We played 3 Ash. We played 3 Veiler. Played 3 Impermanence. And then we have, you know, Talents and Call to round out the deck at 40. So I know a lot of people, I saw someone else topped a case tournament in Orlando, Florida. They were playing just these, and I think it was Talents in the deck. But I don't know, man. I'm just so tired of going second and not opening any hand traps. So I'm like, okay, or like really any like interaction at all. Like even Talents can kind of go to like in that same slot where a hand trap would be. Like, I don't know. I just feel like I need more. So I played 12 and I was like, man, Ash has its problems, but it's such a catch-all. I just felt like, you know, I should include this card. And it was good, but there was times where I would open double Ash, and I'm like, okay, well, this sucks. And of course, that's the merit of these two, is you open doubles of those, and it's like, it doesn't matter. You just use both of them. As actually game one against the Elvis Stun player, the guy that I lost to, I opened Ash, and like, I was like, it was like Ash in like one line of play. And I draw Ash, and then I draw Ash, and I'm like, oh my god, I just can't fucking win. And he has like 5 back row, and just like can't do anything. But so yeah, I don't know. It's got its problems. But the way I was looking at it was, oh, the entire tournament, every time I saw Ash, it could be Reflector or Beast, and it really didn't help me that much either. Just given just the hands that I was provided in the tournament. So I don't know. Like the Ash was fine. It was fine. I don't really have much else to say about it. I'll probably continue playing it going forward just because I feel like we need to have at least 12 slots dedicated to hand traps. I mean, it might be overkill, but like, I'm just so tired of going second and not having any interaction and my opponent just being like free to play. And you know, like, sure, we can top into this, but I don't know. I just wanted to keep it like, I just wanted to be able to more consistently hold up interaction for going second and just kind of make things a little bit more favorable on the die roll, whether it goes like either way, you know what I mean? So this is kind of where I'm at. These 13 with the, you know, the Call by the Grave and then Reborn as an extender and upstart for consistency. I'm going to test this more and, you know, we'll see where it goes from there. But as of right now, this is fine. Extra deck, there's really nothing to say. Speeder, Shaman, Marcher, Quandax. Again, this was the Virtual World QB in the second tournament I played. Herald, Excel, Librarian, Junk Warrior, Stardust Charge, Dragster, Crystal, Chaos Ruler, Omega, Hot Red, Satellite. I destroyed the trap. I 2-0'd the Trap Tricks player because I didn't actually mention this. I played Trap Tricks round 1 on Wednesday, the first tournament. I just satellite popped his board twice. It was insane. Yeah, no, this card's nuts. I don't know why I didn't play it before. Well, I do know why I didn't play it before. I played the Majestic Shooting Star, but yeah, no, this guy's nuts. Definitely can't cut that guy for Baroness. I thought about it. We just cannot cut that card for Baroness. I feel like the only thing we can cut is Quandax. Like, you know, I made that combo video. Leo commented on it, and we had a small discussion. He's like, probably Quandax comes out. We sacrifice the Librarian draws, which I don't even do a lot anyway. So, like I said, when I have a Doppel Tuner line, I just make Excel to make a Herald first before Speeder, so I can just, like, ensure my combo or Force Nib. So yeah, that's kind of where I'm at. Quandex probably comes out for Baroness, which we will be getting in a week, which is super hype. I'm probably going to just end up pre-ordering mine and just shilling out for it because I just need the card. Side is Droll. We have Invoke Dogmatica at my locals, and that deck is really scary, so I want to be prepared for it. Also, the guy that plays Trap Tricks also has Drytron, so, you know, I was like, if he plays that, then I just want to have this card. Also, this can be, like, okay against Try. It's, like, not the greatest, but it's, like, maybe depending on like whatever build they're playing, you might be able to put this in, but you know, that's here nor there. Ruler, this is just, you know, it's Ruler for combo, which no one really played combo, so I never used this once. Twin, Duster, Reboot. So I took the evenlies out of the side so that I could make room for, not strike. This was Nibiru, but I put strikes in. I took the evenlies out so I could make room for these instead, because I feel like order's just, you know, order's fucking crazy. And then reboot and duster might just be better than evenly, because ripping these off the top in a grind could just bail you out. That's kind of the same logic as twin, like ripping twin on the top might just be able that push you can have for game. But it figures I played against fucking set 5 Eldritch when I just really needed to have fucking 3 evenly, 3 twin in the sideboard, and it just go figure. But I always draw evenly too late, so I don't know. The boot was insane. I booted the Trap Tricks guy, and I blew up his board in the second game with a satellite, so that was the 2-0 win. Yeah, I mean, it's like, fine, like, this is good and all, but it's just unfortunate that I didn't see much of this, to be honest. Like, I opened Order Twin against the Altergeist guy, and I'm just like, well, fuck me, man. It's like, he plays Secret Village Pot and all that shit, and I was like, well, maybe I just go for this and don't bother with a twin, and it's just, I don't know, he didn't even really do much anyway. He sided his pots out, so that was probably just a mistake on my end. I probably should just went for the twin against the Geist, but I was like, man, there is a lot of bomb spell cards that might be able to win him out of this game, so. And that guy always has the fucking impermanence for my speeder, so just go figure. But I made it with Converter, so I at least made, like, ended on Crystal Wing and, like, this, I think, and the twin was set. But, you know, I digress. But yeah, I mean, that's the list. 4-3 overall across the two tournaments. Losing out to Trap Deck sucks. But, I mean, I'm overall pleased with it. The deck ran well. I just wish I didn't fucking open the one of Garnets as much as I did. But, you know, it is what it is. These are necessary evils when you play this deck. You just have to play those cards. So, you know, like, comment, sub. Let me know what you guys think. If you have any suggestions, please leave them down below. Links to all of my socials down below as well. If you want to follow me on Twitter, Twitch, or whatever the fuck is else down there. You want to join my Discord as well, which is pretty inactive because really there's no one in there, but I would like to change that. So join my Discord and please start a conversation. That'd be cool. But anyway, see you guys.